वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन क्लासेस डीओ नलगोंडा सेवंथ चैप्टर कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री पार्ट सिक्स। आई एम अंकम श्रीनिवास जेडपीएचएस पेदमुनिगल। इन प्रीवियस पार्ट वी लर्न सेक्शन फार्मूला। व्हाट इज सेक्शन फार्मूला? एम टू एक्स वन प्लस एम वन एक्स टू बाई एम वन प्लस एम टू and m2 y1 plus m1 y2 by m1 plus m2. Using that formula we had done some problems in previous part. Now see one example depend on the section formula. In what ratio does the point minus 4 comma 6 divide the line segment joining the points A minus 6 comma 10 and B 3 comma minus 8. In previous problem we had given two endpoints of the line segment and ratio had given. We had find the point which divides given ratio. Now in this case we given endpoints of line segment A minus 6 comma 10, B 3 comma minus 8, and P also given a point P minus 4 comma 6. So in this case a given end point of the line segment point a given, we have to find the which ratio this point divide the line segment AB. We have to find the ratio. We have to find the ratio. To find the ratio, let us suppose from A to B M1 and from here M2 units. We know that formula, section formula. What is the section formula? Section formula is m2x1 plus m1x2 by m1 plus m2 and m2y1 plus m1y2 by m1 plus M2. We know this formula. Now this is the point of P, the coordinates of P. So my dear children, here to find the ratio given point x coordinates or y coordinate, we have to equalize, then we will get the answer. In this case x coordinate is the minus 4. In formula m2 x1 plus m1 x2 by m1 plus m2, you have to equalize these two. Or y coordinates 6 equal to m2 y1 plus m1 y2 by m1 plus m2. Either take x coordinates are equal or y coordinates are equal. Now P minus 4 comma minus 4 comma 6 is equal to m2 x1, this is the x1, this is the y1, this is the x2, this is the y2. M2 x1, x1 means minus 6 plus m1 x2, M1 we don't know M1 though, right as this M1. X2, what is the X2 here? 3 by M1 plus M2. Now in this I written only X coordinate. When you take the X coordinate, you have to equalize the X coordinate of the P. X coordinate of the P. So I am taking here x coordinate of P equal to minus 4. Minus 4. Dear children, this is the x coordinate of P. This is the y coordinate of P. If you take x coordinate, you take minus 4. If you equalize the y coordinate, this is equal to 6. I am taking x coordinate. Now, minus 6 of 4, minus 6 m2 plus 3 m1. Now you transfer right side, it becomes a minus 4 of m1 plus m2. So, minus 6 m2 plus 3 m1 equal to minus 4 m1 minus 4 m2. Now, here m1 transfer right side, m2 transfer right side, m1 transfer left side. Now, here 3 m1 minus 4 m1 transfer left side plus 4 m1 is equal to here minus 4 m2. Here minus 6 m2 transfer right side, it becomes a plus 6 m2. Now here 3 m1 4 m1, 3 plus 4 7 m1, 7 m1 is equal to minus 4 m2 plus 6 m2, 6 minus 4 2, 2 m2. Now 7 transfer right side, it become a m1 equal to 2 by 7 m2. Now m2 transfer left side, it begin to become a divided by. So here m1 by m2 equal to 2 by 7. So m1 by m2 nothing but m1 is to m2 equal to 2 is to 7. So in this case, a given the endpoint of the line segment, a point which it, point also given to divide the line segment AB, we have to find the ratio in which ratio divide given point the given line segment. So to solve this problem, equalize x coordinate of P or y coordinate of P. Now I have taken here x coordinate, and solving this problem, the m1 is to m2 equal to 2 is to 7. Dear children, of course you may have the doubt, why don't you equalize the second coordinate? You can equalize. So yes, I am solving here. Second coordinates are equal. Second coordinate, what is the second coordinate? M2 y1. M2 y1 minus 10 plus m1 y2. Y2 is the minus 8 by m1 plus m2 is equal to y coordinate. What is the y coordinate here? Y coordinate of P. What is the y coordinate of P? 6. Same method. And 10 into m2. 10 m2 plus minus into plus, it become minus 8 m1 equal 6 of m1 plus m2. 6 of m1 plus m2, then here 6 10 m2 minus 8 m1 is equal to 6 into m1, 6 m1 and 6 m2. Now m2 transfer right side, and here m1 transfer left side, then here minus 8 m1 माइनस सिक्स एम वन इक्वल टू सिक्स एम टू माइनस टेन एम टू. नाउ हियर माइनस एट प्लस माइनस सिक्स माइनस फोर्टीन एम वन इज इक्वल टू टेन माइनस सिक्स फोर माइनस फोर एम टू. नाउ माइनस माइनस विल बी कैंसल एंड फोर एम वन इक्वल टू फोर्टीन एम वन इक्वल टू फोर एम टू. एम वन इक्वल टू फोर बाई फोर्टीन एम टू. नाउ एम टू टू ऑल्सो लेफ्ट साइड एम वन बाई एम टू इक्वल टू फोर बाई फोर्टीन. टू टू सार फोर टू सेवन सार विल गेट टू बाई सेवन. दैट मीन्स एम वन बाई एम टू नथिंग बट एम वन इज टू एम टू. एम वन इज टू एम टू इक्वल टू इज टू सेवन. इन प्रीवियस केस वी गॉट रेशियो टू इज टू सेवन. इन सेकेंड केस वी गॉट टू इज टू सेवन. एंड इन एग्जामिनेशन यू हैव टू डू एनी वन टेकिंग एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट्स आर इक्वल और टेकिंग वाई कोऑर्डिनेट्स आर इक्वल यू विल गेट द रिक्वायर्ड रेशियो. नाउ यू सी इन अनदर प्रॉब्लम एक्सरसाइज 7.2 थर्ड क्वेश्चन. फाइंड द रेशियो इन विच द लाइन सेगमेंट जॉइनिंग माइनस 3, 10 एंड 6, -8 इज डिवाइड बाय -1, 6. इन दिस केस गिवन इंफॉर्मेशन द एंड पॉइंट्स ऑफ लाइन सेगमेंट एंड पॉइंट द कोऑर्डिनेट्स ऑफ पॉइंट -1, 6 विच डिवाइड A is to B. Now we have to find the ratio. In what ratio divide point P the line segment AB? We have to find here M1 is to M2. This is we have to going to find. How much? What is the ratio? In which ratio point B divide the joining of line segment AB. Now in this case to find the ratio we have to equalize x coordinates or y coordinates. First write the section formula. We know that section formula x comma y is equal to what is the section formula? M2 x1 plus M1 x2 by M1 plus M2 and M2 y1 plus M1 y2 by M1 plus M2. We got clearly here. Now this is the section formula. Now to equalize x coordinates or y coordinates, here x value is the x value and this is the y value and here x1 here y1 here x2 comma y2. So equalize the x coordinate or equalize the y coordinate as your wish. You can equalize any one. Suppose if I take here x coordinate is the minus 1. If I take minus 1 is equal to what the x coordinate here? M2 x1. M2 x1. What is x1 value? Minus 3. Plus M1 X2. What is M1 X2 value? 6. By M1 plus M2. We don't know value of the M1 and m2. We are going to find. Now do the cross multiplication. If I do the cross multiplication, minus 1 of m1 plus m2 is equal to minus 3 into m2 minus 3 m2 plus 6 into m1 6 m1. Now minus 1 into m1 minus 1 m1 and minus 1 into m2 minus 1 m2. Here minus 3 m2 plus 6 m1. Now children, m2 terms are right side, m1 6 m1 terms for left side. Always you take m1 left side, m2 terms right side, minus m1 if you transfer left side here, minus 6 m1 equal to minus 3 m2 if you transfer minus m2 right side, it becomes a plus m2. Now here 1 m1 6 m1 total we get the minus 7 m1 is equal to here minus 3 m2 here plus 1 m2 total we get the minus 3 plus 2 how much we get minus 2 minus 2 m2. Now here minus minus will be get cancel, both side minus will be get cancel, m1 equal to we will get the 2 by 7 m2. Now transfer m2 left side, m1 by m2 equal to 2 by 7. Now m1 by m2 nothing but m is to m1 is to m2 equal to 2 is to 7. How is it children? So as you are wish in examination, you can equalize the x coordinates or y coordinates. If any one, you will get the answer. So in section formula, we have only two type of problems. In line segment, end of the line segment always gives end of the line segment. And if we given the point, we have to find the ratio. If we given the ratio, we have to find the point. Only two types. In previous problems also, he always gives end points of the line segment. If we given the point, we have to find the ratio. If we given the ratio, we have to find the point. Now one more example problem here. Find ratio in which the y axis divides the line segment joining the point 5 comma minus 6 and minus 1 comma minus 4. Also find the point of intersection. In this case, point did not given. Point not given. So here point given. So how to get the point? Given the one y-axis. Y-axis divides. So a point on y-axis divides the joining of line segment AB. So we have to suppose a point on y-axis. We know that a point on y-axis x coordinate is 0. Always x coordinate is 0. So let a point on x-axis, y-axis, a point on y-axis, x-coordinate is 0, x-coordinate is 0, y-coordinate take any variable, you take any variable, R, K, L, M, N, R, Y also you can take. So let us suppose a point on y-axis 0 comma y. Now same problem in previous problem also, a given, what is a 5 comma minus 6. B given the endpoints minus 1 comma minus 4. E given endpoint of the line segment, point also given. What is the point here? The point P, P 0 comma y, 0 comma y. So is point x coordinate, we know the x coordinate is the 0 and y coordinate is the variable. So in this case we have to equalize only x coordinates. In previous problem, if we equalize x coordinate, we will get the ratio, or equalize y coordinates, we will get the answer. In a special case, intersecting x axis or y axis, we have take only specific coordinate. When the given the y axis, a point on y axis, x coordinate equals 0, that means constant. So in this case you equalize only x coordinate. Now what is the x coordinate, what is the section formula? Section formula m2x1 plus m1x1 by m1 plus m2 and m2y1 plus m1y2 by m1 plus m2. Always write the section formula first. Then we return here given information and section formula. Now equalize only x coordinate. Why you are equal only x coordinate? We know the x coordinate as a constant. So x coordinate is m2 x1 plus m1 x2 by x2, m1 x2, m1 x2 by m1 plus m2 equal to 0. Now what is the m2 x1, what is the x1 here? 5. M1 x2, what is the x2 here? Minus 1. Clearly we know that minus 1. Now children, cross multiplication, this become right side, goes to right side, become 0 into 0 of m1 plus m2. Here 5 m2 minus 1 m1 is equal to 0 of m1 plus m2. We know that 0 into something always 0. And here 5 m2 minus m1 equal to 0. Now you transfer right side m2, we will get here minus m1 is equal to minus 5 m2. Minus minus will be get cancel, and we will get here m1 equal to 5 m2. If you transfer, m2 is left side, become here m1 by m2 equal to 5. 5 you can write here, we will get 5 here, you can write 5 by 1. Because what is the coefficient of m1? The coefficient of m1 is 1. 1 transfer right side divided by 1. So 5 by 1, nothing but 5. 5 can be right 5 by 1. Now what is the ratio here? We will get m1 is to m2 equal to 5 is to 1. 5 is to 1. Very easy problem, children. Now first, suppose a point on y axis, 0 comma any variable I have taken as y, then equalize only x coordinate. In this case I equalize the x coordinate, and doing so we finally got the ratio 5 is to 1. Then he asking the question, one more question. Also find the point. How to find the point? We suppose the a point on y axis 0 comma y. 0 is the constant, y value we don't know. So if you get the y value, we can write the point 0 comma and y value. So my dear children, here see y equal to m2 y1 plus m1 y2 by m1 plus m2. We know this formula. Now y equal to m2. What is m2 here? 1. What is m1 here? 5. All we solve the m1 and m2 value. M1 as 5 units and m2 is 1 unit. So m2 is 1 and m1 is 5 by 1 plus 5. Now what is the m2 y1? Y1, this is the y1 minus 6, and m1 y2, what is the y2 here? Minus 4. Now here minus 1 comma 6 minus 6, 5 comma minus 4 minus 20 by 1 plus 5, 6 equal minus 26 by 6. And here in 2 table, 2 3s are and 2 1s are, 2 3s are, and we will get the y equal to minus 13 by 3. We got clear information. So required point is what is the required point? 0 comma y. That means y value we got here minus 13 comma 3. So what is the required point? The required point is 0 comma minus 13 by 3. This is the final answer. Very easy, children. This problem you may get in examination for 4 marks question. How easy, children? You know, if we given the find the ratio in which the x axis divide the joining the line segment given 2 points, then you have to suppose a point on x axis x comma 0. Then when the given the y axis divides, we have to equalize y coordinates. Y in a point on x axis, y coordinate is the 0. So we can take only y axis, then we will get the ratio. In competition examination, suppose in polytechnic, any other competition exam, TS, WRS, any competition examination, if we get the like this problem, we can solve within 4 seconds or 10 seconds. Within 10 seconds, you can solve this problem. Here, see children, given points is the 5 comma minus 6 minus 1 comma 4. The ratio in which divide y axis the joining of line segment given 2 points, very easy to find this formula. Minus x1 is to x2. Very easy this problem, children. Very easy this formula. Minus of x1, what is the x1 value here? 5. Is to x2 minus 1. Minus minus will be cancelled. 5 is to 1. How easy? So when you get in examination and a competitive examination, time sense is most important. Using this method you can get answer, but to solve short time very easily, this is the minus x1 is to x2, minus x1 is to x2, we will get the answer. One more problem, you have to prepare yourself, find the ratio in which x-axis, when you take the x-axis, to find the ratio very easy, that is the minus y1 is to y2. The formula to find the x-axis divides the line segment joining given two points is minus y1 is to y2. Using this formula, this technique, we can solve within 10 seconds. Now see another example. Find the ratio in which the x-axis divide the line segment joining the points 3 comma minus 6 and 5 comma 4. In previous problem, given y-axis, in this case given the x-axis. So let us suppose a point on x-axis. We know that a point on x-axis y coordinate is 0. So a point on the x-axis x comma 0. Dear children, here clearly a point on y-axis is always y coordinate is 0. X coordinate how much we don't know, so we have to take as a variable, I taken as x. So let a point on the x axis be 0 comma x comma 0, then points given the end of line segment always gives the end of the line segment, and let us suppose 3 comma minus 6 and b 5 comma 4, and let us have point P x comma 0. So in this case, given end point of line segment, a point which divides the joining of line segment AB, that point assume ourselves, that means a point on x axis is x comma 0. In this case, x coordinate is a variable, we don't know that value, y coordinate is the 0 constant. So in this case you have to equalize only y coordinate. So y coordinate y equal to m2 y1 plus m1 y2 by m1 plus m2. What is the y coordinate here? 0. 0 equal to m2, we don't know. Y1 value is the x1 is a y1, x2 and y2. So m2 y1 minus 6 plus m1 y2 4 by m1 plus m2. Now if you transfer left side, 0 into something become a 0. So 0 of m1 plus m2 equal to minus 6 m2 plus 4 m1. Now 0 into something will get always 0, remaining minus 6 m2 plus here 4 m1 equal to 0. Now you transfer right side, this one will get 4m1 equal to 6m2. 4 transfer right side become a m1 equal to 6 by 4m2. M2 transfer left side, m1 by m2 equal to 6 by 4, 2 2s are 2, 3s are 3 by 2. So m1 is 2, m2 equal to 3 is to 2. This is the solution to find the ratio, divide the x-axis as given the line segment. Using this the process for the 2 marks question and 4 marks question in summative examination. In competition exams, in previous I said, what the x-axis divide a line segment joining of any two points? What is the answer? Minus y1 is to y2. Using this formula, you can solve very easy. What is the y1 here? What is the y1 is to y2? Minus y1 is to y2. What is the minus y1 here? Minus 6. Is to y2. Y2 is the 4. This is minus or minus plus. So 6 is to 4. 2 3s are, 2 2s are, 3 is to 2. So using this technique, this tip, you can solve very easily. Thank you very much. Welcome to online classes DEO Nalagonda. I am yours Ankam Srinivas. In previous class we learned applications of section formula. One more application on section formula is the centroid. What is a centroid? Centroid is a point, the congruent point of medians of a triangle. What is the median? The median is a line segment joining vertex and midpoint of opposite side. Suppose if I take ABCD is a triangle and this is the, let us suppose, is the midpoint, and joining this midpoint and vertex is called the median, one median. So AD is a median. Now through B and midpoint of AC, let us suppose E, joining of is the BE is the another median. Also through C you can draw third median. These three medians are intersecting at a point. That point is called the centroid, is denoted by G. The congruent point of medians of a triangle is known as centroid. What is a centroid? The congruent point of medians of a triangle is called centroid. In centroid, it has the one specific characteristic, that is the centroid divides median into 2:1, divides in the ratio 2:1. Suppose if we take the one median here and this is the G centroid, the point G divides AD in the ratio of 2:1. The centroid divides every median in the ratio of 2:1. This is the basic property of the centroid. Now using this ratio, we are going to find the coordinates of the centroid. So let us suppose A x1 y1, B x2 y2, and C x3 y3. And suppose A x1 y1, B x2 y2, C x3 y3. Now take the centroid as G. We have to find the coordinates of the G, then we can get coordinates of the centroid. Now before to find the centroid, we have to find the coordinates of D. What is the D? Midpoint of BC. What is the midpoint formula? Sum of first coordinates by 2, comma second coordinates by 2. So midpoint of BC become x2 plus x3 by 2, comma y2 plus y3 by 2. Now midpoint formula, sum of the x coordinates by 2, sum of the y coordinates by 2. Now children, it given the clearly one point A, x1, y1, other end point D, x2 plus x3 by 2, comma y1 plus y3 by 2. Now we have to find the G, coordinates of G, such that this point divides line segment AB 2 is to 1. So 2 is the M1 and 1 is the M2. What is the section formula? What is the section formula? M2 x1 plus M1 x2 by M1 plus M2 and M2 y1 plus M1 y2 by M1 plus M2. Very easy. Now here, what is the M2 here? 1. What is the M1 here? 2. X1 is a y1, this is the x2 and the y2. So G equal to, we get M2, 1 of x1 means x1 plus 2 of x2, second coordinate, it is x2 plus x3 by 2 by M1 plus M2, 2 plus 1, and y coordinate, 1 of y1 plus 2 of y2 plus y3 by 2 whole by 2 plus 1. Now x1 of 1, x1 plus 2, 2 will be cancelled, x2 plus x3 by 2 plus 1, 3, and 1 into y1 will get the y1 plus 2, 2 will be cancelled, y2 plus y3 by 3. So what are the coordinates of G? X1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3, y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3, and these coordinates are coordinates of the centroid. So you can write here centroid equal to, centroid G equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 2, 3, y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3. So to find the centroid, sum of the x coordinates of three vertices and sum of the y coordinates of three vertices of a triangle. We had derived the formula centroid x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3, comma y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3. Using this formula, we have to do some problems. I had given the three examples. First example problem, find the centroid of the triangle whose vertices are minus 4 comma 6, 2 comma minus 2 and 2 comma 5. First write the centroid formula. What is the centroid formula? Centroid G equal x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3, comma y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3. Now here G equal to, very easy, first sum of the first coordinates, x, x value, x value, sum of the all x coordinates by 2, minus 4 प्लस टू प्लस टू बाय थ्री. देन वाई कोऑर्डिनेट्स, ना वर वाई कोऑर्डिनेट्स सिक्स प्लस माइनस टू प्लस फाइव बाय थ्री. नाउ सी हियर, माइनस फोर प्लस टू प्लस टू, टू प्लस टू फोर, फोर प्लस माइनस फोर जीरो, जीरो बाय थ्री. एंड सिक्स माइनस टू फोर, फोर प्लस फाइव नाइन, नाइन बाय थ्री. सो जीरो बाय समथिंग जीरो. एंड नाइन बाय थ्री, थ्री थ्री सा नाइन, सो थ्री. What are the coordinates of centroid 0 comma 3? Very easy problem. This type of questions you may get in examination half mark or 1 mark. Now another example, if 5 comma minus 2, minus 2 comma 7 and 0 comma 1 are vertices of a triangle, then find coordinates of the intersecting point of medians of a triangle. In previous question he given the find the centroid. In this case asking the question, find the coordinates of intersecting point of medians of a triangle. Intersecting point of medians of a triangle, nothing but centroid. So write the centroid formula. X1 plus X2 plus X3 by 3 comma Y1 plus Y2 plus Y3 by 3. So the coordinates of intersecting point of medians of a triangle, nothing but centroid. So in previous problem we solved one type of problem using same formula. You can find yourself, do yourself. And now go to the other example. A 3 comma minus 5, B minus 4, 7 comma 4 are the two vertices of a triangle ABC, and coordinates of centroid is 2 comma minus 1. Then find the coordinates of the third vertex C. Now centroid formula, we know that G equal to X1 plus X2 plus X3 by 3 comma Y1 plus Y2 plus Y3 by 3. Now what are the points given here? A 3 comma minus 5, B minus 7 comma 4, let C X comma Y, and G here G given 2 comma minus 1. Substitute these values in this, we will get sum of the first two coordinates 3 plus minus 7 plus X by 3 comma second coordinates minus 5 plus 4 plus Y by 3 equal centroid, coordinates of centroid 2 comma minus 1. Here 3 plus minus 7 will get minus 4 plus X by 3 comma, here minus 5 plus 4 will get minus 1 plus Y by 3 is equal to 2 comma 1. When two points are equal, two order pairs are equal, X coordinates are equal and also Y coordinates are equal. So here first X coordinates minus 4 plus X by 3 equal to 2, and minus 1 plus Y by 3 equal to minus 1. We are going to solve these two equations. Now if 3 transfer right side, minus 4 plus x equal 3 2s are 6. Now transfer right side this one, x equal to 6 plus 4. 6 plus 4 how much? 10. Then second equation, if you transfer 3 right side, become into minus 1 plus y equal minus 1 into 3 how much? Minus 3. If you transfer minus 1 right side, it become plus y equal minus 3 plus 1 equal to minus 2. So x equal to 10, y equal to 2. So the coordinates of C become 10 comma minus 2. So the coordinates of point C, 10 comma minus 2, will get, depend on the centroid, only two type of problems. When the given the four or three vertices of a triangle, we have to find the centroid. In second case, we will give the two vertices of a triangle and centroid, we have to find the third vertex. Thank you very much for watching my video.